So the Wildlife Forensics Lab services casework for wildlife officers. We might do something, for example, DNA analysis on a poaching case. We're letting the DNA tell the story of what happened in these cases. So a lot of times, the stories that the wildlife officers might be bringing with their evidence samples or what they hear from the different reporting parties may not be the true story. And we're letting the DNA tell what happened. It solves the puzzle, essentially.
The lab has received 18 IVA cases since the passing of AB 96. I've worked on 17 of those cases directly, and I have personally examined over 250 pieces of ivory and reported those as either ivory or bone or some type of synthetic, such as plastic. So I'll be looking for distinguishing physical or morphological features that are present in the tusks or tooths of ivory-bearing mammals. The different types of ivory-bearing species that we can identify based on morphological characteristics include elephant, mammoth, hippo, walrus, narwhal, warthog, sperm whale, and killer whale. What I'd like people to know about the work that goes on here is that we are really committed to the highest standards and ideals of science, and that because it's wildlife forensics inherently, there's a lot of background that goes on to just writing a report or giving an answer, because everything we do can and is expected to go to trial. So there's a lot of background validation research that goes on for each of the species that we're able to identify, or for any of the individual DNA matching that we can do.
We're continuing to try and develop more and more methods for more species, be able to do, essentially the goal would be to be able to answer any question about wildlife that's happening within the state, from a law enforcement perspective.